You got to tell me when you're going to do that.
Okay, that was the warm-up. I'm stretching out. All right, are we ready?
Yes.
All right. I would like to call the meeting officially to order. If we can have Councilmember Camara lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Okay. Thank you, board members, stakeholders, and visitors. Put your right hand over your heart and repeat after me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Got Thai food coming, Howard?
We have Mexican food coming.
Very good. Roll call, Mr. Secretary, please.
Today's last day.
Okay. Oops. Be patient with me. It was a very hot day, and I'm not quite here. But so if I make a mistake, please let me know. President Thomas.
Here.
Vice President Benjamin.
Here.
Secretary Hendry. Here. Treasurer Hopp.
Here.
Ms. Havari.
She's coming late. She texted me. It's all good.
Ms. Meyer.
Here.
Mr. Lazarovitz.
Here.
Mr. Martin.
Jerry is here somewhere. What? I saw him.
I saw him.
Yeah.
He's getting the ice chest with Guillermo. Oh. He's here.
Okay. We'll take that as a yes. Ms. Skelton.
Here.
Mr. Camara.
Here.
Mr. Rileko.
Here.
No. Here. Yes. Okay. Mr. Anand.
Present.
Mr. De La Cuesta.
Here.
Ms. Patton. Mr. Lynn.
Ms. Patton is not here yet.
Okay. Mr. Lynn.
Here.
Mr. Luna.
Here.
Mr. Marabi.
Here.
Ms. Raines. Mr. Robbins.
Here.
Ms. Esgarian. Anybody I missed? Very good. We have a quorum?
Very good. On the end.
Oh, yes, Mr. Noel. Okay. That's why I asked at the very beginning. Please, we'll get it straight after that. Thank you.
Very good. Comments from the chair. I have nothing at this time. Public comment. The one and only, Candido. What do we got? Well, I only have this one. Well, Miriam, it wouldn't be our council meeting without hearing from you, so come on down.
It's just a really bad thing that they're picking on people. Some people just because others make it bad for others. Like, there were a couple guys that came, Zuma Dog and his buddy. They all came in for 3-4 years, made it bad. And so then we had other people coming in, and Herman, the city attorney, I don't know, but he would like to see them go. He doesn't want them coming. I think they have the right to come, as long as they're not acting violent or threatening people or anything. he disrupts the meeting a lot, okay? Grant you that. Okay, they asked him to leave. But the point is, I think they're overreacting at times. I think they're being very hard on him, and I think they should ease
Thank you,
off.
Jason.
Stop cutting back our speaking time from 7 minutes to 5 minutes public speaking down. 4 minutes for agenda and 1 minute for public comment.
Thank you, Miriam.
And I just want to say I'm Bud Griff, and I guess I've been in, just one more thing. I've been told I can have the 5 minutes speaking for behalf of Van Nuys Neighbor Council.
All right.
That's what I've been told, right?
Yes.
Thank you.
Next up, Jason Ackerman.
My name is Jason Ackerman. I'm currently the VNNC representative for the neighborhood council. Part of my this is my phone.
It is not.
He's going to check.
All right,
I'll encompasses Ventura Victory, Balboa's 405. One of the treasures of this area is the Tapia Brothers Farm. About 20-some-odd years ago, the voters of the city of Los Angeles passed Proposition K. One of the items in that was to expand Gelte Fields on Burbank. That's H-J-E-L-T-E. If you haven't been there, it's four really poorly maintained baseball diamonds in the middle of the fields that Tapia Brothers uses to farm on. I was under the impression that we had smoothed this out because Parks and Rec wants one of these parcels to expand Gelte Fields as per mandated in Prop K, but I have a feeling that if, first off, it was a line item of like one of 84 or something like that projects, and there was no clear explanation that expanding Gelte Fields is cutting into Tapia Brothers farmland. So I thought we could do that by the end of last year, but apparently the new brass at the top for Army Corps and Parks and Rec has gone and started putting pressure on Army Corps to kick Tapia Brothers off that parcel as soon as possible. Which last time I checked, was not the status quo. They were not going to pursue that particular project for a while, and Tapia Brothers was supposed to be able to use it for a couple of years. But Army Corps sent a letter to Tom Tapia at the end of the month asking to vacate parcel 13 by the 29th of September, which is
time's up.
And so Tom talked to Vicky at the Army Corps, and she gave until the end of the year, which is still pretty ridiculous, but I guess it gives them time to harvest those crops.
We at the Encino Neighborhood Council passed a resolution opposing the loss of any additional agricultural land within the Sepulveda Basin, and apparently that was not clearly enough worded. So I'm now going to be drafting and circulating a motion for Encino, Lake Balboa, and Van Nuys to oppose the expansion of the Gelte Fields facility into any adjacent plots that are currently being used for agricultural purposes. So obviously this is too late to be on the agenda for this month, but I'll be submitting it for next month for an agenda item, and we very much appreciate your support in helping to save the last functioning farm in the San Fernando Valley. Thank you. I'm opposing it because we already have a lot of soccer fields in Encino. And a lot of baseball fields in Encino. We've got this public sports complex. We got all those soccer fields down Balboa. The problem is if they expand this particular property, it's going to cut the Tapia fields into two sections. Right now it's like a giant C around Gelte Fields, and what they're going to do is cut out the middle of that C. So it's going to mean,
that's what they call an expansion, by cutting it in half.
Yeah, they're expanding Gelte Fields I'll discuss this next month. Thank
Beautiful.
You.
So email the language to info@vnnc.org and we'll get it on the agenda.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you, Jason. Miriam, you've already spoken during this round. If Donna can speak later, absolutely. Candido.
Yes, sir. Council today, and Derek, those of you who would like Jeff and John and Maria, Derek, we're going to miss you. For me, you've always been what Van Nuys it was going to be like. I mean, you bring a lot of class to this place. You're dedicated. You're not afraid to talk about the issues. You're not afraid to confront people. But what we care about is that you and your lovely wife are going to have a child soon. And so if you'll come on up, we'd like to give you a little something. Mr. President, we were told by Jay Handel and by Dunn that as long as he does not take this until after the meeting's over, it's okay. So I'm going to hold it up.
Okay.
And this is for you and your lovely wife and for your wonderful child. And we all got together because we want to thank you, honestly. I hope that we see you around here and that, honestly, I just hope that by the time your child's grown and you're still living in Van Nuys, there's somewhere that he'll be proud of or she'll be proud of, because we still got a lot of work here in Van Nuys. And some people are happy and they think it's good out here, but it isn't. There's a lot to be done, and I know that. I hope we get you back, buddy. I hope we really see you one day. So, anybody else want to?
Go ahead.
Derek, it's been made friends for a long time. A lot of good things together.
Hey, follow.
You did.
We'll hide the
kids.
How about you?
Okay, one
I'm
more.
So tired. Okay. Thank you, guys.
How you doing?
Very nice. Thank you, Derek. Kamsamnida. All right, that concludes public comment for this time until Donna walks in the room, and then we'll just stop the meeting and let her talk. Up next, we have the secretary's report and the approval of August minutes. Mr. Hendry.
The minutes were posted. I assume they were posted on Facebook, correct?
I believe so.
Okay. If anybody had any questions?
Do you have a copy of them?
Unfortunately, I do not. I happen to have been out in the sun until about 6 o'clock tonight. If you wanted to put them over, I could get you a copy.
All right. Whatever. I like your minutes. They're very concise.
I generally try to. I couldn't get it at the last
time. Caps lock.
Yeah. Very concise.
Very important stuff. So, Mr. Secretary, should we approve the August minutes?
If that's the general opinion, yes.
Okay, I make a motion that we approve the August minutes.
Second.
With that, I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
Okay. President Thomas.
I'm voting yes.
Vice President Benjamin.
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, yes. Ms. Hopp.
Aye.
Ms. Havard has arrived. No, not yet.
Not yet.
Ms. Meyer.
Abstain.
Okay. Mr. Lazarevitz.
Aye.
Mr. Martin.
Aye.
Ms. Skelton.
Abstain.
Mr. Kamara.
Yes.
Mr. Vallejo.
Yes.
Mr. Anon.
Abstain.
Okay. Mr. De La Cuesta.
Abstain.
Ms. Padden.
Yes.
Mr. Lynn.
Yes.
Mr. Luna.
Abstain.
Okay. Mr. Marabi.
Yes.
Ms. Raines. Mr. Robbins.
Yes.
Mrs. Garian, not yet. Okay, Mr. Knoll.
Abstain.
And I do understand the abstains, and I wished I had had a copy here. They were posted, however.
Very good. Do you have anything else for us, Mr. Secretary?
The bank meeting should be tomorrow night, and I would be going.
Very good. All right, moving on. Item 6, Treasurer's Report. Ms. Hopp.
Oh, hold on. Be ready. Okay. We have funding issues, you know, as well as...
Is that microphone working over there?
Our regular one. Yeah, you want to bring it up here. Thank you. Okay, let me get the thing back out. All right. For our monthly expenditures, they were minuscule in August. We spent a whopping total of, hold on a second, $461.63. And the reason it was that much was $450 was for the storage for a few months, so we're ahead because of the budget change. And $1,163 was for water for the meeting. We did have $999 for a neighborhood purpose grant, which was supposed to have been paid months ago, and the check never got to them, and I never saw a void from the bank. That was for the Valley Bakery, so I reissued that. It was approved quite some time ago. I believe it was July of the end of last year or August. That left us with $22.73 in outreach, $1,368.54 in the neighborhood purpose grants, and they put some money in our account to help us out. So we had $10,034.50, and that's for that. Then we had some neighborhood purpose grants on which we were going to be voting. One was for the Mid Valley Police Council, and we've discussed it a couple times. We didn't take a vote. This is to qualify for matching funds that are to be used to put up the to put the graffiti preventive.
The ivy.
Ivy stuff up, yeah, and to beautify the old building and clean it up. And they're asking for an amount not to exceed $2,500. Also, we have the Village and Family Services asking us for a rather large grant. I have all of the paperwork, but I know Mr. Robbins doesn't understand the process, and I need for him to know that when they ask for the amount in which he's asking, which is $5,000, that needs to go to Jeff Brill and be made into a contract, and it has to be approved by Dunn ahead of time. I don't get to just automatically write a check on one that large. So if we decide we want to vote on a smaller amount, $2,500 or less, then that can be.
You did.
But we, but I know, but I couldn't find.
For $1,000.
But I couldn't find the voting form, so I want a new voting form because that's what they asked me for. So I will give them what they want because then I don't have to complain. You know, they don't have to complain. So I give, you know, we vote on $2,500 if that's what we approved, and or whatever amount it was, and then we'll go ahead. And I actually thought it was $1,000 and then $1,500, but whatever the case, doesn't matter. We can do $2,500 now. Was it $999?
It was.
I knew it was less. Anyway, so whatever you guys decide you want to allot, let me know. Someone speak up, and then we can vote on it.
We can't vote on during your treasurer's report.
It's, you have to vote on the funding items. Okay, then the other.
You can't take any action during a report like this.
Okay, I stand corrected. The last one is for, hang on. It's also been approved, but again, I didn't have the ticking of the approval. So, and this was for the emergency preparedness one that we are getting together with a couple of other councils. Bill? That would be Granada Hills, North Hills, Lake Balboa. And it's for the 8th Annual Valley Disaster Preparedness Fair. And they were asking for, what were they asking for?
1,500.
Hang on, 1,000?
I thought it was 1,500.
Oh, well, it says here 1,000. So you, if you guys want to do 1,500, again, it's up to you guys. I'm just saying that's what's on this. So if we want to write it out for 1,500, we can do that. Pardon me?
Their paperwork test is 1,000?
Look on this.
I believe I'm just asking. Second, because we have it as 1,500 on this.
I know. Well, because that's what this thing said that they gave me. It's the Southern California Preparedness Foundation, and they filled in 1,000. So it's you guys, you know, can do what you want, but that's what this says. And it's signed by the people, William Hopkins and Linda Pruitt.
That's it.
So if that's, you know, what they're asking for, that's what we'll give them, unless you want to give them more. It's up to you.
All right, so then should we make a motion to approve the
minutes?
Treasurer's report? We already did the minutes.
Yeah, you need to do that.
Do we have copies? Yes, Maria.
Can I get a copy of a
treasurer's
breakdown
report
and a balance? Do you have any?
Do I have the printout here with me? Probably, but do I have a copy? No, I have one. And I don't usually give that out because then I'm going to not have it when I need it for my stuff to send in. What, this? No, and it doesn't need to be either. So I have.
Well, she could just look at it.
I have the bank form right here for our checking account. Gives the number. And it shows the amounts in whatever plus the money they added in. And it shows exactly what I just said. And then I have my paperwork that I always write. So if you want to come look at it, you're welcome. Can I circulate it?
Right.
Yeah, as long as I make sure I get it back, because otherwise we're screwed.
You will.
All right, so send it on down to her.
Should be making copies.
Very good. So with that, I make a motion that we approve the treasurer's report.
Seconded.
With that, I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
Okay. President Thomas.
Yes.
Vice President Benjamin.
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, aye. Treasurer Hopp.
Aye.
Ms. Havard.
Yes.
Ms. Meyer.
Yes.
Mr. Lazarevitz.
Yes.
Mr. Martin.
Yes.
Ms. Skelton.
Abstain.
What?
Mr. Kamara.
Yes.
Mr. Waleko.
Abstain.
Mr. Anand?
Yes.
That was a yes. Okay, Mr. De La Cuesta?
Abstain.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Lynn?
Abstain.
Mr. Luna?
Yes.
Mr. Marabi?
Yes.
Ms. Raines is not here. Mr. Robbins?
Yes.
Ms. Kazarian is not here. And Mr. Knoll?
Yes.
Fifteen aye.
Very good. Committee chairperson's reports. I usually leave out Maria, so I'm going to go ahead and start with her. So, Ms. Skelton, outreach report, please.
Yes.
Thank you.
Mr. George, all the texts and stuff that I sent you. See, Q usually handled the photos, so I always send him my photos. So that's why I sent you all the photos.
Okay, well, Carino's back with a vengeance, so you loop him back in on all of that stuff.
And Mr. George, you have to respond to my text about...
I'm going
to
do that right now.
No, I just thought it was outreach, because for, remember, there was a moment for a few months after the election, for some reason I couldn't get into the building for me to have my outreach meetings. So that's when I was bringing people here, and you said it was okay, but when I finally looked at the website, it says, like, outreach haven't done anything since 2014. But I do understand, like you told me, it means no specific meetings can have a meeting if there was no location.
Well, circle so back with Guillermo and check on the little room and when you can use it, and then we'll just set a specific date.
I did that two times with y'all, and I showed up to the room, and it was locked. Doors
but he's
locked.
The man with the master list, and everything
well,
goes through him on that.
Both of y'all gave me permission in June and January as well.
Okay, but instead of...
Again.
Was it agendized?
No. We will loop in Guillermo, and we will start the outreach meetings once a month again.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Okay, back to outreach. We had an awesome time with the mayor's Summer Night Lights event. It was awesome. The community showed up and showed out. I was the big mouth cheerleader for the baseball team. We put a whooping on y'all police department. The police department was talking so much smack. Oh, gosh. Oh, and none of them here. We put a whooping, and that tape is on. We put a whooping on your police department. They could not handle us. Our community showed up, showed out. We did good. The event was extremely good. The Summer Night Lights, there was no fights, no arguments, no nothing. The police was extremely involved with coming around and always being at the park. It was a great event. I wish y'all could have been there. I got an award. I got a certificate for all of my stuff that I've been doing, and I sent you the photo so you can forward it to him. So am I still now able to go across the street to the guy to go get, okay, to do the photos? I will be bringing other people here next time, but most definitely I just want to say thank you. The Summer Night Light program was extremely, extremely good. The name of my team was ooh, ooh, because that's what I'm known by at the park. A lot of people don't know my name, but they call me ooh, ooh. I know, I don't even know. But I was the big mouth cheerleader, and we put a whooping on y'all police department. Go tell them I said, Maria. But other than that, thank you for everything. Thanks.
Candido.
Thank you, Ms. President. Maria's not patting herself on the back enough. First of all, we participated with her on a couple of times. Maria is the mascot of Delaney Park. She's the patient. If we get more interaction between the police department and a lot of these kids...
To get a whooping, right?
No, so they understand that
thank you.
He doesn't know which one is which. Want to see them succeed, want to see them go on to greater good rather than end up in prison. They're not there to arrest them. They don't have to fear them. And that's what Maria's doing there, Mr. President. So when you talk about her achievements and the achievements of this neighborhood council. But what she still isn't telling you is that since Father Rodolfo passed away, we have cut back with the food bank. Her church has stepped
Rocket Valley.
Your minister and all of the
good
people.
Yes, I love her.
Everybody ties to you, Maria. So, Mr. President, you have an outstanding person.
Good work, Ms. Skelton.
Thank you. Oh, and talking about the church, the pastor says she would like to see you Sunday. For some reason, she loves you more than me. Really? Oh, and Van Nuys Neighborhood Council, I went out. I don't know if y'all heard about that young lady that was on the news. Her daughter went to go take the trash out and didn't come back. So I went there. I went to help her, you know, pass out flyers. Of course, y'all know I am an extreme couponer. So I gave her a whole bunch of body wash and stuff like that just for her and the family to try to help her, you know, even though it was in North Hills where the incident happened. But when it comes down to when a child is missing, my son went through that phase running away. Hell, he's in jail now, but running away, whatever the situation may be. You know, we all still need to help out our kids. So it didn't matter that she was in North Hills and the issue happened in North Hills. Luckily, the young lady is back home, but I did go there and I did help her. And on behalf of that, she wants to come and say thank you to Van Nuys Neighborhood Council.
Very good. All right, any other committee chairs have anything to report or we can continue on?
Yes, actually, let me make a quickie. I have the budget advocates. I'm going to go brief on that. And while we're touting our own horns, I guess I can say that Kathleen and I have gone to several events that Assemblymember Adrian Nazarian has placed in our laps. One of them was a senior preparedness emergency meeting. We also went to two of the Obamacare ones and so many of the others in the meantime that I can't even remember them all because I don't usually pat myself on the back, but Kathleen and I have been very busy going to a lot of those things, and we're doing it on behalf of the neighborhood council and the community. Now, you're welcome. Okay, while I'm at it, also real quick, the only thing I wanted to tell you that really is disturbing, if you can find my little report.
Oh, not yet.
I've got it buried here someplace, of course, because that's always the way it is. It's my report for the
Yeah, exactly.
It's my budget advocates one, and it has to do with the water. Jeez, I can't believe that I just had it here. Maybe I left it in here. Oh, yep, here it is. Never mind. Nope, that's not it. Shoot. Sorry, one sec. I was organized until you guys asked me to read everything. Now I can't find anything. Come on. Okay, that's not it.
Can you see her?
Here it is. It's stuck behind something. Ha-ha, I knew I had it right here. Okay, thank you so much, sweetie pie. Sorry. Okay, basically what I want you to know is that I was really shocked when I went, and I haven't sent this information to the other budget advocates yet. We've had a number of committee meetings with individual departments already, and I missed the one on this a week ago Monday night because that's our executive meeting, so I can't be in two places at once. But they do know that my heart's with them. Quickly, UC Davis advised the drought has cost us $2.7 billion thus far. They say that there have been 462,000 jobs created this year, and a campaign to replace lawns with drought-resistant plants was launched across LA and the state. A water bond sponsored by Assemblymember Nazarian was passed in 2014. They were supposed to address measures to prevent future problems from the drought. There were presentations from the DWP and from someone representing the farmers union. I'll get to that in a second. Also, MWD Metropolitan Water District was there speaking to us, and they told us that they serve 19 million people with water, and they and their subsidiaries, they have 4 million acre feet of water. A football field holds 1 acre foot, so if they have 4 million acre feet, you can imagine how much water that is, in storage. And they've always had storage. They don't let us know that they have that. But what is the first thing they do when there's a drought? DWP raises our rates and tells us we have to conserve. Well, now when you get to a little bit further down in this, I'll tell you that they are getting less than the allotment they're supposed to get, which is one of the reasons they're concerned. The California Delta, where they got a lot of the water from, has a number of endangered species there. So as a result, because of another bill that had been passed, they were receiving less and less water. 65% was their allotment in 2012. They received 35% in 2013, and the largest reduction was in 2014, taken down to 5%. So that is kind of scary, but they still have that 4 million acre feet of water in storage. This year, they're receiving 20%, so it's going up in addition to that storage. Since 1985, there have been more than 5 million people served, extra 5 million people served, and there have been no increases in water acreage. The MWD has invested heavily in storage. They have a huge reservoir. The work with brown water recovery and sometimes other situations, and I'm not so sure I like the brown water because if they're using it for irrigation, maybe that's okay, except that we've had some contamination of our vegetables from the farmers, which might have something to do with it. Sometimes they purchase water when they're really desperate or they think they are. 8 of the last 10 years have been a very below normal snowfall in the Sierra Nevadas. So that means they're getting less water coming down. So they get, you know, a fair amount from the Colorado River, which we've always known. But this year they're raising their estimate of how much they're going to get from 59% to 95%. And the reason for that is because of the expected El Nino. Now, if that doesn't come, we got a problem. Okay, let me hurry up.
Okay.
What really gets me is the problem that only 5% of the water usage is from urban usage. 40.1% is the farmers. And 51.1% is big business. Why is it that we're always getting dunned for the increases and told to conserve when we hardly use any at all? And what? And if we do conserve, basically what they told us was it doesn't make a hill of beans difference. So I just thought I'd mention that to you. We still have the odd even watering days and all of that. But bottom line, we're kind of getting rooked in this situation. And I just thought it was only fair that you guys would know that.
Very good.
Candy, did you have something to follow up on that?
Yeah.
If Ms. Hopp is done, I'd like to ask her a question. Ms. Hopp, are we down to 2 times a week as far as watering that?
They told us 3 days. One of them is for, you get 3 days a week if you're, there's 3 days a week for Monday, Wednesday, Friday for the odd, and Tuesday, Thursday, Sunday for the even numbers.
3 days.
Yes, they haven't decreased that. What was the other thing? Let me see, hold on, 34 million is considerable. Oh, and the one thing that really got me also is they spent $34 million to put shade balls in the reservoir.
Well.
And the reason they did that was because the chlorine that's in the water, which wouldn't have to be there if it was dirty water, was being activated by sunlight and causing a cancer, causing chemical to develop. So in order not to kill us all, they had to put the shade balls in there to protect the water so that that wouldn't happen. Now that I understand, but $34 million? Okay, so I found that a very interesting water summit, and I wish more of you had been there because I think you'd probably had some of the same reactions I did. Anyway, thank you.
Very good. All right, moving on. Anything else from the committee chairs? All right, we're going to...
George?
Yes, Greeno. Plum Committee, what's happening?
I just want to say I apologize for taking a leave of absence during the time. Just want to let you know that the people who won the Great Street Challenge doesn't want to get involved with the neighborhood council because of the email that was sent to them and also the PRA. So the problem is that this whole Great Streets, we've been talking about it for a couple of years, and all of a sudden we can't get involved with something like this, which is important for the community. And that's what's part of it. And And that's the reason why I took the leave of absence, because I'm supportive of what they're doing. They received the highest score of all the Great Streets winners, which is a great thing, but they don't want to be involved with the neighborhood council just because they don't feel safe. And they just, at this point, they won't come back until they feel like they're safe. So I just leave it at this moment, but hopefully the board could resolve this matter and move forward, because it's very important, you know, for us to get involved. But at this point, they're not. So.
Very